finish it off, please. Up and... Okay.
So it's been a delicate one, and a one I did not want to try and make worse. I wanted to try and back off a little bit.
We've done the circular port, O'Brien, we're coming up. The body language dropped again. As soon as you're almost telling us it didn't go as fantastically as I had hoped, and you can't advertise that.
If something positive does happen and he does try to apply one of my corrections, then I will immediately try and acknowledge that. Maybe that's just a discovery process. I know I did that when I was younger. I like to question everything because then I found out more.
I'm pleased you get excited. I'm pleased that adrenaline does kick in and that we want to perform and et cetera and get carried away. It's not a bad thing. It's channeling that energy.
And it's almost he has become obsessed with his personal classical technique. And of course, the more, the higher up you get and the more intense the training is and the closer you get to becoming a professional, the more crucial it is to improve yourself and get better, and it becomes more analytical. And the fun can get drawn out of it, out of the equation. And I think it's important that he tries to find that back again. But he's the only one that can do that.
I introduce you to a very, very distinguished guest, and I'm very honoured.
And then one day, Leigh's class had a visitor, ballet legend Frederick Franklin, who worked with some of the greatest names in dance, including Dame Alicia Markova, Balanchine, and Sir Frederick Ashton.
It's lovely to see you all, and I have never been to this place, and it's just fantastic. You have, when I remember what we rehearsed in years and years and years ago, and now this is so great. Anyway, I'm looking forward to all of this. Have a good time.
Okay, Jeff.
We've got to be in the somber mood about the future, whatever. And I think it's important you come up with your own scenario that you can relate to yourself and maybe a little bit of your life, and then it becomes a little bit more real. Just be careful that we don't just evenly walk out this whole
thing. The overall impression to me, he talks like a dancer, he moves like a dancer.
Very nice, 1, 2. The step... And
there's something mature about him. You know, I think he's starting at a very early age, at 11, away from home. It's made a difference.
All right, let's stop a second. Doing very well, good. Clear steps, so you need to know how many steps you're going to take. So if it's just 1, 2, 3, and going. This is all fine.
He is a very gifted young man. They're rare birds. He's a pure classical dancer. They don't grow on the trees. But he's been given the gifts, all they need now to be worked on and to be developed.
Just finishing up here, just come through and run.
It's all there, the instrument, which is the most important thing, it's there. I don't know whether he realizes all of this. And if he gets down on himself, he must realize that it's quite rare that the gifts he's been given. And those gifts have to be taken care of. They must. And that now it's going to be up to him. I mean, a real classical dancer, male, they're very rare, they are. And I think he must realize what he's got. And they are gifts, and he must take care of them.
Stop. It was awful. Why? You see, if I was to say it wasn't, you're not going to believe me, are you? No. So it sort of leaves me in a position where there's little I can do. Yeah, you've got to take yourself to the next stage. Now, the next stage is not technical, funny enough, at all. It's about you stepping over that hurdle of managing to believe in yourself a little bit and allowing yourself to be human, which means it's not going to be perfect. And I think that's far more interesting anyway, because you've still got things to work on. Life's a bit more interesting. Who wants to be perfect? Yeah?
I wanted to rush out and say, do it. You know, he'd grit the teeth and it doesn't matter. I mean, if he were on a stage, what would happen? He'd have to go through. And it's that's, he must think of it when he's doing, it's a performance. And the performance value is everything.
Pick it up as if nothing's happened, because you have to give that to the audience. You have to give that to yourself. I can't take you from there over to there. You've got to do it. But you agree with the principle.
Yeah.
What is it then that's going to get you past that stage? And it's called growing up time. And I don't mean that in a condescending fashion. I mean, it's going into the adult professional world and you're a year away from it. Can you? Even if you fatigue, even if you fall, you know, everything's crumbling around, can you actually pick yourself up and continue? Because that's the strength of someone.
Did it.
Good. Pleased?
Yeah.
Hurdle done. Jeez, well done. Next stage. Good. No excuses anymore. Very, very good. Well done. That's a big, big leap forward, Leigh, honestly.
You've been given many gifts and have to be taken care of, you know? You have a line. Don't worry about the silly pirouettes, that they'll all be there, that'll come. Mm. Do you know, the thing is, Leigh, you're an entertainer. Above all, you're an entertainer. And that's what it's all about. That's the theatrical part of the business. The beauty of the business is what you've been given and what you make of the lovely things you have. And you're only 18. And you know, Leigh, it's all out there. And the road is beautiful. And you must enjoy it.
6 weeks. I don't have enough, but I'm not carried on. I sort of started school then.
Well, that's really, you know, I started when I was 4. Now I'm, you know, I'll go back a long way, but it was the armistice of the World War, 1918. And they brought a gramophone into the house.
There's usually the Limbury Studio Theatre, which is a small one inside, and then there's usually just one big matinee performance at the Opera House, which is good.
Now, Leigh, have they called you Billy Elliot yet?
They have.
Well, you know, let's face it, we're both from the north part of the country, and under similar circumstances, you know. So it pertains to you and it pertains to me, which is wonderful. And, you know, Leigh, you've been given many lovely things. Now, you know, don't negate them. They're God-given gifts. They are. Hang on to them. They're yours. Now, just make the most of them, because you can.
All the groups, except for when we do the twos, just change your mind. We can save a bit of time. So that means, Leigh, you're going in the first group. That means you're going to be on this side.
With less than a month to the assessments, even nerves of steel are tested. And then Monica Mason, artistic director of the Royal Ballet Company, arrives. Next
three. Everyone gets terrified from the assessments because it is such a decider. It isn't guaranteed your place. It's very much like the audition from White Lodge into upper school. It is a huge career defining moment, I think, for this, you know, for us sort of younger generation. It is a huge decider. It is, you know, it's deciding if they're good enough to have a career or not.
All right, well, that was very interesting, just coming in there at the last minute. How did you feel about it?
It wasn't too bad. There's some things I kept on, like, not getting so right.
That's okay, but having me there, but more particularly Monica Mason, artistic director of the Royal Ballet, how was that?
A little bit, yeah, I was nervous.
A bit nervous?
Yeah.
Okay, but what I was impressed about was that you kept going and that you didn't throw yourself around, you didn't hurl yourself anywhere so that things didn't work. And although you're doing it all now, we're still not getting, as Mr. Powley said, the head up, the presentation, the chest lifted. That's what you need to do. That's the last missing ingredient. So it was interesting to come in today and to see the end of the class, and not only with me sitting there, but also the artistic director of the Royal Ballet to come in, and I thought, well, this will be a tester. And I'm very pleased to say that he didn't stop and he did continue and the work was good. He didn't present as much as he should, but there was a vestige of trying. He sets very high standards for himself. Monica Mason picked that up straight away when she looked at him and she said he's very hard on himself. You can see that. He's concentrating too much on himself. And so I suggested to him that he stops thinking about himself and the way he's dancing and rather the gift that he's giving to people sitting in the audience. Because your dancing is an expression of the music and movement, but it's also a gift to the people that are sitting there watching you. And if he thinks about that, he thinks about other people watching rather than himself, then hopefully that might carry over a little bit. But he is obviously very demanding, very sensitive, and a very artistic person, all of which can be wonderful, but can also be self-destructive. So we've got to teach him the skills to turn it around. I did say to him, you know, we all want you to succeed. Your success will be our success. We've done everything we can to try and help you, but the last step is up to you.
I have never really stopped trying. And I am willing, because I'm very stubborn and I'm not likely to back down from a challenge, so I will keep trying. I have this underlying sort of determination that I'm going to prove I can do it, I'm worthy of this. Good, thanks. How are you?
You're doing well.
Yeah, I'm doing really well. Thank you very much.
Okay, now look, when you're really making the entrance, just stand for a moment and then come on and just feel confident. And just let the love of the dancing, the way you love it, flow right through you and enjoy the wonderful talents that you have. It's all there for you to take. Now look, in the good American ways, Leigh, just go for it.
Thank you.
Dear Leigh, it's my pleasure to inform you that you've successfully passed all of your second year appraisals and qualified for a second year graduate year.
Well done!
Quick! As you know, the final year of the upper school course is by invitation only and is offered to those students whom the members of the staff and the appraisal panel feel are capable of moving into the professional world of classical dance.
It's brilliant. Ooh, so chuffed.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare.
Hello, Freddie?
Yes.
Hi, it's Leigh.
Leigh, tell me.
And I'm through to next year.
Oh, oh, isn't that marvellous? Winds,
sailing on summer breeze, and skipping over the ocean like a stone. Everybody's talking.
That's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. You've worked hard, Pat.
Only the echoes of my mind. I won't let you leave my love behind. No, I won't let you leave.